things that people create are stories. People create tales all the time, and very successfully. So you don't also have to have only one story in a work. For example, Crimes and Misdemeanors, the movie by Woody Allen, has a crime story and a misdemeanor story. They deal with the same thematic material, but none of the characters show up in either one. They exist in the same world, but they don't ever encounter each other. And they go along independently, Martin Landau being the main character in one story, and Woody Allen being the main character in the other. And in the end, the two sit on a bench at a party, on a piano bench, and they compare notes of what happens in their lives. And then the message of the story is comparing one person's story and what happened to him to another person's story and what happened to him. But they're two separate stories in the same movie, completely independent, aside from bringing them together only at the end to make the audience draw the comparison between these two life stories, or these two segments of life stories. So when you're telling a tale, there's nothing wrong with a tale. And many fine screenplays and many fine books are done that are tales. There's also things you can do, like you can do, like Virginia Woolf, a chain of thought, where you just go from one thought to another, to another, to another, and it doesn't have to have any pattern. All it has to do is be an intriguing place to go next. It doesn't even have to mean anything, necessarily. It just has to be an intriguing place to go next. She kind of invented that method of writing a story. So a work, a finished work, can be a story or a tale. It doesn't even have to be a tale. Just like art can be almost photorealism, it can be impressionism, it can be modern art that doesn't have any particular meaning, it can be modern art that doesn't have a meaning, even the creator of it, the painter, didn't know what it meant. But what makes good modern art better than bad modern art? It's because the painter has an intuitive sense, a subconscious sense, that at putting these things in this position will create an impact. He doesn't know what impact it'll have on an individual. But he knows that he's put a volatile atmosphere in his work of symbols and colors and shapes and dynamics that anyone who comes up to it will be affected strongly and come up with their own interpretation. That's a talent and an ability, and you can do it with words too, so that you can put things together that don't necessarily have to have any even intended meaning on your behalf. You just put in things that you know will have, if I put up the two words here, just coming to my mind right now, as an example, dagger and tongue, okay? Now, that's going to affect all of you. I guarantee it. You all start thinking about images. Your writers, especially as an audience, you're going to think about, well, what would dagger have to do with tongue? Is dagger in a tongue? Is the tongue used as a dagger? Is the pen mightier in the sword? What, you know? Okay? You can do all kinds of things. But you're all going to think of ideas. This will affect you. So something like that, just putting those two words together, becomes a piece of art, okay? It is art. Because I have intentionally done something that other than just putting something like a shopping list, which might not affect you at all, bread and milk, you know, okay, big deal. Okay, you see it all the time. Dagger and tongue, you probably don't see all the time. And by choosing those two things, something organic and rather unprotected, and something non-organic and very dangerous, okay, together, it's going to spur some thoughts. So when you read a novel and you see all these different things, all these techniques are open to you. No theory of structure can help with those. It's all intuitive. And that's more the kind of thing we'll be talking about tomorrow and doing that sort of thing. But structure is when you have something specific you want to communicate, a particular point you want to make, a particular message you're trying to get across, or you're trying to make an argument, as we talked about. Then you need structure, because that forms the underpinnings of your argument. Okay. So, but all this other stuff, it's neither better nor worse. It's different. Okay. And tales, you can tell great tales. Stories, you can tell great stories. Things like this, you can do that very impactfully. Intending something, or even not intending something, but just having a feel for what will move your audience or your reader. You can do it with words, you can do it with pictures, you can do it with sculpture, in all these areas. But when it comes down to having something in mind that you wish to communicate, that's when you need a carrier wave. That's when you need a structure. Because you want to make sure that what you've got up here is accurately reproduced out there.